Hi everyone, so today I'm going to review the two of the latest launches by L'Oreal. L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Stay Fresh Foundation, Liquid Foundation and the Powder Foundation. Okay, let me tell you about the price first. The foundation retails for $13.25, the liquid one. And the powder foundation retails for $12.50, which is quite steep for a drugstore brand. But you know, we all know L'Oreal for its pricing and all. The liquid foundation comes in, this foundation comes in 11 shades and couple of shades have cool tones and others have warm tones. I was matched with honey, which was way too light for my skin, for my complexion. So I had to go back and change my shade and now I have amber, which you, as you can see, is quite close to my skin tone. The skin or third darkest shade in the range. And the powder foundation is only available in 4 shades and I've got the darkest one, which is warm sand. And for a reference, I'm NC42 in MAC. Comes in a glass bottle and it has a cool pump. I'll use this foundation, I'll apply this foundation with this Real Techniques sponge because the consistency of the foundation is quite thick. I'm just taking one pump at the moment. See, it's pretty thick. So I'm going to dab the foundation. So as you can see, I have applied the foundation on half of my face and you can see the difference. This side of my face looks pretty much flawless. So I'm pretty pleased with the coverage. So now I'm going to do my the rest of my face. For some reasons, my camera always shows that I'm applying a lighter foundation, which is not the case, because when I click the pictures after doing the video, you can see the foundation is a perfect match for me. But for some reason, it always shows that I'm applying a way lighter foundation. My face looks pretty much even toned, and I can call it flawless. And I used only one pump of the foundation, so this foundation is pretty good in terms of coverage, and little goes a long way. And if you have blemishes, you can always go back and apply more foundation. But what I'll do, I'm not going to apply any concealer so that you guys can see how it looks after I apply the powder. I'm going to take a large powder brush to apply this. You can see this has pretty strong yellow tones. I'm not sure if it's not that visible on the camera, but the powder, which is warm beige, has pretty strong yellow tones, which is what I like the most about this powder. And but only con is it doesn't come with a mirror and the packaging is quite flimsy. This is what you call it for the price you pay. And let me see if it has a mirror or something. Oh yes, it has a mirror. It has a very nice looking this full size mirror here, and it has a sponge also, which I'm not going to use. You can always use the sponge if you're applying it on the go. I'm going to gently dab my brush in the powder like this and I'm going to sweep it. This is how the product looks on my face after 15 minutes of application, and I am really liking the effect, and I'm really pleased with the coverage. The coverage is really good. And the formula is nice. It's not very moisturizing or anything. It doesn't feel heavy on the skin. And what I like the most about it, despite of being someone with dry skin, I do not like products that have a dewy finish or glowy finish. Generally gravitate towards the mattifying formulas. This product is not very mattifying, but then it doesn't give a dewy finish, so it's somewhere in between. So I am sure it will work both for dry and oily skin girls. But yes, if you have very oily skin, then you should probably be applying a primer underneath. I haven't seen the product oxidizing on me. I wore it for almost 6 hours yesterday. And I hope you enjoyed this first impression kind of a video. And if you liked it, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. And please subscribe for more. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.